had been a combat veteran in the Army in World War I, wounded in action, received the Purple Heart, and had a 20% disability for the rest of his life because bad weather, cold weather, winter, whatever, would bother that leg. So, December 7th, 1941, I came home from school a couple of days later and was all set, ready to go join the military and go sign up in the Navy. My dad said, no, it's going to be a long war. Go back to school, come back in May, and meanwhile I'll look for an officer program for you. So that's what I did. I came back and found a program, and I applied for it. It was an officer program at the United States Merchant Marine Academy. Upon graduation, I received a commission as an ensign in the Naval Reserve. Went on active duty immediately. During my period of time at that school, we were required to spend 6 months at sea. I ended up spending 7.5 months on an ammunition ship, made 3 trips from the East Coast, one to the port of Casablanca, the second to the port of Oran, and the third to the port of Algiers in Algeria. I was in as a midshipman on an ammo ship. Yes, yeah, we'd had 95 to 100 ships in a convoy, and the subs would come up at night. They'd get underneath the big ship and recharge their batteries. And then daytime, like one time we were in the rear because we had like 9,000 tons of bombs on board. So that would have been a right plum, but they got a tanker carrying avgas right in the next, the guy I'd call Coffin Corner, he's right at the end, and they nailed him. And our ship, the ship just heeled over. I thought we'd been hit, I really did. Well, if we'd been hit, nobody would have ever known it. We'd have gone up like a rocket. So after getting my commission, I was assigned to an AKA, which is an attack cargo ship. What that means, you don't load the ship for the maximum amount of cargo that the ship can carry. You load the ship at a level so that the particular equipment you're going to use in assaulting a beachhead or to support the troops when they're already ashore, you can have ready access to that. So this was what that was. And we steamed around the South Pacific for 6, 7, 8, 9 months, I guess. And then in February of 45, we invaded Iwo Jima. And I had fun changing over and becoming a boat officer for a couple of days, during which time we're taking in live Marines and equipment and bringing back the dead and the wounded. Yeah, scary experience. You don't have time to be scared, though. You do what it is you have to do. No one is ever born a hero. You do what you have to do. And if it comes out on the other side of it, you did an incredibly great job, then that's wonderful. Particularly that a friend of mine was on, and it was a new commanding officer, and his range of his firepower was insufficient to reach the troops that were moving steadily further inland. So he kept bringing the ship closer, and eventually he ran it aground. And this friend of mine was an ensign on the ship that day. When he ran it aground, we needed to lighten the bow of the ship so it would get off the rocks or whatever. So they started shifting ammunition from the forward magazines aft and setting it on the stern, on the fantail. Well, it did not take too long for the Japanese to go, So they fired at the ship, and the next thing you know, they blew it to kingdom come because they hit all the ammunition that was on the fantail. My friend was on the opposite side of the ship, and he was blown overboard. It was he and one Navy chief petty officer. They were the only two that survived.
Wow.
Yeah, but you do a lot of stupid things, but you do things under the press of combat. You do the best you can. It may work, it may not, but you do the best you can. As I look back over the years and the war and everything else, we didn't really need to invade Okinawa. We lost a lot of troops unnecessarily in Okinawa. I felt eight. Great life. I'd do the same thing over, probably. But if, as I said to Alana earlier today, if I was given one more shot, I'd go to medical school. Only because I could serve humanity. And I believe President Obama has brought something to the White House that we haven't seen in 8 years. One word, decency. Cut.